Hello children, once again welcome back to the session. We have seen what is mean by light. Now we are going to discuss the properties of light, reflection of light, refraction, diffraction, interference, polarization, dispersion and then scattering of light. Totally we have 7 properties of light. We are going to discuss it one by one. First have a heading, reflection of light. So what is mean by reflection? Reflection is when light bounces off an object. If the surface is smooth and shiny like glass, water or polished metal. Okay, so the reflection is nothing but if we are having a ball, we are throwing the ball on a wall. While we are throwing the ball on a wall, the ball bounces back. What happens to that ball? It bounces back. This is called as reflection. Likewise, when light falls on any smooth, shiny surface, like glass, water or polished metal, the light bounces back. This is called as reflection. So reflection is nothing but keep in mind the ball. If you are throwing the ball on a wall, it comes back. Likewise, when light falls on any shiny surface, it comes back. The light comes back. This is called as reflection. So look at here, we are able to see the reflection in mirror. Whether we are able to see reflection in wood or any irregular surface? No. So reflection occurs only in smooth shiny surface. So looking at the mirror, we are able to get a reflection. So what happens here? First, the light falls on us. So the light which are emitted by our body falls on the mirror. The light which is emitted by our body falls on the mirror and it reflects back. So what is the first step? Light is absorbed by our body and our body emits that light. This emitted light from our body falls on the mirror. It reflects. So this is a process how reflection occurs. Shall we move on to the second one? Yes. Refraction of light. What is it? Refraction of light. Look at here. Refraction is the bending of light or sound wave or the way the light bends when entering the eye to form image in the retina. So simply we can tell bending of light is called refraction. Consider if you are walking on the road. We are walking. If there is any obstacles in front of us, what will we do? We'll change our path, right? So likewise, when light comes and falls, so due to that obstacle, the light rays are bent to another way. This is called as refraction. And one more thing is, our eyes see the light. So the light particles which enters into our eyes, what is it? The light particles which enters through our eye are bent. So when they reaches the eye, the light particles which are reaching our eyes are bent. When they reaches our eyes and they form as an image in the retina. Look at here. So this is the example of refraction. So I can show you an example, children. So look at this, children. What is the example is? Take a glass beaker. Keep a pencil inside it. Take a glass beaker and keep the pencil inside it and observe that on the other side. So consider this is the beaker and observe this on the other side. You are able to see that pencil in the bent form inside the water. Whether we have seen, whether anyone experienced this, children? Shall we do this activity, children? So take a water in some transparent material. So look at here, I have taken water in this. So I kept something inside this. If I am observing it on the one side, if I am observing it, I am able to see this pelican in bent form. I am able to see this as bent form. You can try this experiment, okay? If I am observing this like this, I am able to see it is in bent. But it is not really bent. Only the light particles are bent. So this is different medium, right? So this is gas medium and it is water medium. Okay, what is this? Gas medium here. Above it is gas medium and here it is water medium. So the light rays enters to a different medium. So what happens? The light rays are bent while entering into the water medium. So that is why we can see this in a bent form. If you are observing it, it would appear like a bent. But this is not really bent. Only the light rays are bent. Clear, children? Whether you will do this activity, if you want, you can. If you are observing it like this, okay? You can see it in the bent form. Clear, children? So, shall we move on to the next one? So, the bending of light waves is called refraction. Look at here. This is the original wave. When it enters into a new medium, the light rays are refracted, that is bent. This is called as refraction of light. Light bends inverse because the speed of light is low, that is slower in water medium. Light travels fast in air medium compared to water medium, it is slow. Now we are move on to the next. What is the next? Diffraction of light. What is it? Diffraction of light. Diffraction is the spreading out of waves as they pass through an aperture or barrier. Aperture is nothing but it is a small hole. Aperture is nothing but it is a small hole. Look at this. Diffraction is the spread of light waves. So the light from this side passes into this hole. So when they comes out through the other side, they are in the spreaded form. So this is called as spreading of light or diffraction of light. Look at here. One light ray enters into this small hole. On the other side, the light rays are in spreaded form. This is called as diffraction of light. What is the first one, children, we have seen? Reflection of light, refraction of light. Now we have seen diffraction of light. Okay? And then, have you noted all these three properties of light? Now we move on to the next. That is interference of light. Interference is the phenomenon in which two or more waves superimpose to form a resultant wave. What is it? Interference is a phenomenon in which two or more waves superimpose, that is combined together. Two or more waves combined together to form a resultant wave. Look at here. You have a wave called X. Light ray called as X and one more Y. When this X and Y combine together, they produce a new wave. This is called as interference. So compared to these two, this light waves has more light energy. More energy. This is called as interference of light. Clear, children? Interference is the phenomenon in which there may be superimposition is nothing but combine. Two or more waves combine to give one resultant wave. This is called as interference of light. So you can draw this diagram also for your easy understanding. Okay, children? Now the next property. Polarization of light. What is this polarization of light? Look at here. Polarization is the phenomena in which waves of light or other radiation are restricted in one direction. So light spread in all direction. Yes or no, children? Light rays spread out in all direction. So sending the light wave only in one particular direction is called vibration, is called as polarization. Look at here. We get a beam of light. We have a light beam here. So the light which comes out from the source comes out in all the direction. Look at here. So this yellow, up down direction and left right direction. So the light is spread out in all the direction. So it is called as unpolarized light. What is it? Unpolarized light. Look at here, you are able to see one blue color, right? And when yellow color. So these are the direction of light which comes out from the light source. Now we want only one direction of light. We need only one direction of light. So we use a polarizer. What is it? Polarizer. This is used to send the light waves in one direction. When the light waves passes through this polarizer, we are able to get a polarized light. Look at here. Now the light rays are only in one direction. We are not able to see this blue colored way here. Yes or no, children? I will tell you again. Just listen. When light comes out from a source, when light comes out from a source, it spread out in all direction. But we want only the light to come in only one direction. So we use a polarizer. The work of polarizer is to cut the unwanted waves and send the light only in one particular direction. Send the light only in one particular direction. So when the source of light passes through this polarizer, you are able to get the light only in one direction. This process is called as polarization of light. And the light from the source is called unpolarized light. After passing through the polarizer, it is called as polarized light. So the points which are here to remember is unpolarized light, polarizer, polarized light. Polarized means only in one direction, unpolarized is in all the directions. So where this is used? This is used for research purpose. This polarization of light is used in the field of research. Okay, children? Shall we move on to the next? Dispersion of light. What is the next topic? Dispersion of light. The separation of light into different color is called light dispersion. What is it? The separation of color. So what is the color of light? We are able to see only white light. Yes or no? The rays which reaches us from the sun is white light. If you are keeping the scale in sunlight, have you observed that, children? If not, take your scale. Okay? Take your scale. That is the not wooden scale, glass scale. Okay? Use your scale and see that in a sunlight, you are able to see different colors of light. So this process is called dispersion of light. So look at here, children, what is this? White light, this is called as prism. What is it? Prism. When white light is passed through a glass prism, or we can consider as a scale also. Okay. So I said you scale only for reference. But in the lab, for separation of colors, we use prism. This is called as prism. It is made up of glass. While you are back to school, I will show you all these materials. Okay. When white light passes through the prism, it splits up into 7 different colors called as vibgia. So where this vibgia is used? In rainbow. Okay, children, we will continue the remaining in the next class. Thank you.